Am I dyeing my hair in every video now? You know it's dirty when you take the band out and the ponytail still stays. I don't know if I've ever let the fade and the roots get this far. It's even actually blue on the ends, which hasn't happened for years. It's because I've been swimming a lot lately, and so I've washed it more times to get the chlorine out. So this particular bleach and dye is needed more than ever. Okay, this is happening. I'm just singing good songs in my head and trying to think of nice things.
In the dream, Stutley looks out across his abundant, thriving apple orchard and watches as half the orchard turns black and dies.
I just had sweat drip out from under my bleach glove. All right, and now we have the fabulous, wonderful waiting time. I'm sorry to say, fellas, we gotta tidy up, or rather I gotta tidy up and you can sit there and watch me. Oh, besides boring tidying, I'm pretty sure this is an update that you guys have not seen. My fae altar used to be down here next to the other ones, but I decided to move it up because this cube was empty. I don't know if I've mentioned this before, but this is a relatively new method of organizing that I'm using. This is a box from Tiffany's, as a matter of fact. I know you would never associate me with that brand, but I bought my mum a glass from them because a drinking glass is the only thing I can afford. I got it for her Christmas present and it came in this like giant box. And this box happens to be the perfect size for nearly all of my journals here, including my grimoires, so I decided to keep them in there rather than in, you know, a precarious pile. And something cool that I got recently, this amazing Lifeline, like a type of charity shop, opened up right near us, that is actually like really well done and like styled, and it's like it's a proper one that's done beautifully. And so Mum and I went right in and I found this balloon stamp, which I absolutely love so much because I only have one other stamp, which is the floral one here. And I also found one of these reverse purses, which I'm obsessed with, where, you know, you push it another way and there's a different color. There we go. If you push it this way, there's silver. These did not exist like at all when I was a kid, and so now, even though they're for kids, I still like want to have one. So I was very happy to find this. I'm not sure what I'll put in it, but I know I had to get it. It's like Jojo Siwa slash Mardi Gras chic, and that's been my aesthetic forever before I knew Jojo and before I went to Mardi Gras, lol. Oh, there's some flowers there. A free toothbrush from a dentist that I have effectively ruined by using it to flick paint like this. I'm sure we've all done that if we like to do abstract painting. And then, oh, these are the absolute MVP, these crayons. Oh my god, I think I've had them since I was like, oh god, like maybe they were Mum's first, but I think I've had them since I was 10 or 11, and they are just the best thing for bright, abstract smudging, I find. All right, so let's keep tidying this and I'll show you when it's finished. The dye and the glad wrap are on. Time to keep tidying.
Okay, the desk is pretty clear. I tend to keep things out if I've been using them quite commonly, so that's why those textures are there, that's why the journals are there, because I'm using them constantly. These are papers for, you know, overspray, overpaint papers. Yes, this is better, and so now I have to turn to the nightmare that is this floor.
You'll rip. I was just reviewing footage on this camera, but also footage of a TikTok that I'm making about my hair. Yes, another one. And there is a whole ass like patch of dark hair at the like back crown of my head that the bleach somehow didn't cover. Like I covered every single other bit in bleach, like over and over it was reeking, and I somehow missed this spot and like, oh my god. It's dark and the purple is dark as well, so it's not like it's gonna stand out. I'm not doing pastel pink or something. So like, that's a meme. All right, dye's washed out. Nothing to do but keep on tidying. Maybe I'll do something fun afterwards.
I don't know what I was going for there, like maybe a I've been tidying all day and it's making me crazy kind of manic face, but no, that's this is a crime against humanity.
If you're wondering what I'm wearing to tidy up all of this mess, yes, I do have an Outlander dress that I got from Redbubble a few years ago. Probably very illegally, because it's just using this image and the artist took it, but I've worn it over ballet clothes, and today I'm wearing it to tidy up the rooms, so, you know. Hey Sasanak, hey Jamie, what's up?
The floor, it be finished. Chores are done, it's time for fun.
Okay, we're in the living room because the light is better in here and I've put my hair up high because having it low down and on your neck when it's hot is horrible, it makes you sweat. All long hair havers know what I'm talking about. But I've been working a little bit in my grimoires and journals today, but I've been working on stuff and I'm kind of halfway through it. I'm not finished yet, and I like to show you guys finished stuff. You know, if it's something like one of my sticker drives that doesn't take very long, then I like to do it on camera. But a lot of this other stuff I've been doing, if I tried to do it on camera, it would just be like, I'd have to bring it out here because there's no room for my camera in my bedroom where I work. I'd just be, and it'd be ridiculous. So I thought I would show you some finished pages in my grimoire, because I've done 3 in a row.
And then you only filmed 2 of them, Tess, you absolute cabbage.
Recently, that I'm actually really, really proud of. And I don't know if you guys have seen much of my grimoire, maybe, or I've got 3 now, so 1 of them. I think it's because they're not entirely finished, all of them, so I don't want to give you a flip through until everything's done. But I'm really proud of these pages, and they're relevant to the new year, like that's what they're for. So I'm gonna show you anyway, and I hope you like them. I decided that this year I wanted to have sort of a power word, which a lot of people do, and I eventually decided that it was trust. I've written down here what that actually means, so let's just look at that. Trusting in the universe, not everything is awful and dark, like it's so easy for me to just kind of move through the world and just think, you know, why would anything good ever happen ever again? So I need to trust that there is some good shit that is coming my way, some good shit that's coming all of our way, hopefully, of course. Trust in my loved ones, because I'm sure it's very common, like whether you have mental health issues, diagnosed or not. Doesn't John Mulaney have a joke about that?
Do my friends hate me, or do I just need to go to sleep?
It's like, that's just saying, like, stop worrying, they love you, they're good people, you are loved by them, you love them, it's all fine.
trust in my dreams, they will come true in a way, because sometimes the way that a dream comes true isn't the way that you originally planned on, but they will come true in some way, and that way will be good. Trust in my goals, they are valid, and I kind of meant that in the sense of my goals used to be a certain thing, and now they've had to change, like as my world and my life has changed, and as well as the world has changed, of course. Trust in my skills and respect them. That's basically saying that I often completely disrespect what I have actually learned and just give myself zero credit for the work that I've done. Hey kid, you're not an idiot. You've actually worked very hard and it shows. Respect in my choices.
I meant trust in my choices.
Meaning that if I make a different choice than somebody else, whether it's a choice I want to make or a choice that I have to make, e.g. the choice I have to make is writing screenplays instead of film productions because of lockdown. And I always think of my life as being magical, like even before I started my magical practice. So make my choices for myself and do not think about what other people are doing. I'm so terrible at that. I am the queen of comparing myself to other people. I should not do it. And then trust in my growth. It is true, meaning even if it feels like nothing is changing, I am growing, like my life is growing, the world is growing. I originally didn't know, I got this written, and I didn't know how I wanted to decorate over here. And eventually I painted it like black and it looked like absolute garbage. So I went to one of my most special books that I have. I'll just show it to you. Hang on. I got this incredible book by the editors of Enchanted Living. And I am a very lucky ducky who could afford, and I found and could also afford, two copies of this book. One I just read that is pristine on my shelf, and then another I actually keep so I can cut it out, because there are so many amazing images in it and I knew I wanted them for wall art and for collaging. I just thought that I would go for purple because my signatures for like important stuff tend to be either rainbow, which is over here, I'll show you that in a minute, this one, or purple. Like if I really wanna set something in stone and make it really, really important to catch my eye, I tend to do it purple. So I was looking for something that was purple. There's the section on edible flowers. There was that bit of lavender. I was like, whatever. And then I came to, this is where the page was, candied violets. And it was this. I don't know if you can see, I'll show you up close, but this is actually violet flowers that have got sugar on them. They've been dried and turned into a dessert. Put that in. I think it looks absolutely goddamn beautiful, and I actually went over it in a silver metallic watercolor just to make it a little bit metallic, but the watercolors are quite translucent, so that's why you can still see the purple, of course. I put the silver foil on it in a few places, like just to fill up this spot because it was a bit blank. There wasn't a flower there. Same with this. So I was just framing it with the foil. And then I used my new balloon stamp. I went over it in purple. I think it looks beautiful. It really reflects my kind of fairy aesthetic that I have. Like it's really ethereal. I have a lot of different aesthetics that I love, but my signature really is purple. I therefore love that this moment of my fairy aesthetic is attached to such important resolutions and my power word that I want to keep on my mind for this year. After I did this, it was purple and it was beautiful, but I knew I wanted to go in my other aesthetic, which is basically rainbow. That's an aesthetic that just everyone associates with me, including you guys. I did some, was it watercolor or pastel? I knew I wanted to do a rainbow sort of gradation here. When in doubt, do rainbow is kind of my rule. So I did yellow, orange, red, hot pink, purple, blue, little bit of turquoise and then over to green. I knew what I wanted to do was kind of have them peeking through a lot of other stuff. Just so much details. In all, I spent about 2 days on it and just finding all of these little things that were in so many different folders. You really want to bring everything together. That's what I wanted to do. I don't always have time to do that. Cheetah's calligraphy that I've been using in my books for a long time. I just love that these two pages are what everyone associates with me, purple on one side, crazy rainbow on the other. So I am very excited to go into the new year with these guys, you know, really holding out my power word and really representing my resolutions. All right, darlings, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that little peek into my grimoire, a little show off a bit of creativity for you. I always try to do some kind of art or prettiness to show you in every video. So subscribe if you enjoy my brand of rainbow chaos or purple or magic or collage or whatever you want. And give this video a like. That would be great. And thank you for being here. I love you. Keep going.